Intro to jumps. So jumping is a common character animation exercise. Here we see a pencil test for a jump and a another sort of stop motion composited exercise. Now, one of the things which is fundamental in a successful jump is having a good path of action. And for something like an inanimate object, like this hammer, we know that the path of action for the center of gravity is a parabolic arc. So we see that in these frames of the hammer as it's flying through the air. For character jumping, it's very much the same parabolic path of action if we can track the center of gravity. Here's another example of a person jumping and tracking their position. Let's see that in slow motion. Now, if you look at this somewhat carefully, and here we're tracking the waistline of the person, the resulting graph of the height on each frame is noticeably flatter around the apex. So they almost look as if they have a straightened path of action, like they're flying. Now, this effect is primarily due in this jump due to the swinging motion of the legs. So what's happening is the center of gravity, which I've marked here in green, is actually following a parabolic path of action. What's being tracked is not the center of gravity, but the location of the waistline, and that is flatter because the center of gravity has actually shifted higher in the torso when the person swings their legs upward. So that is what causes this illusion that the center of gravity in this big jump is flatter. This is something which is well known in ballet. The large leaps, like the grand jeté, ballet dancer appears to be traveling almost in a straight line, but that's because the motion of their legs upward shifts the center of gravity higher in the torso, and that produces an apparent path of action which is straighter than a parabolic arc. There's a very nice book on physics and the art of dance. If you have any interest in dance, I highly recommend it. Now, the other aspect about the time in the air for a jump, this is something which we already know how to determine the time that something is flying in the air, because it's the same as for inanimate objects, as we did with basic falling motion. So you may recall this table, which was discussed with falling motion. So the time it takes for all objects to fall, say, from a height of 12 inches is 6 frames. And this table gives different heights. So if we have a character that jumps, and they jump to a height of 1 foot, then we know it takes 6 frames to fall from a height of 1 foot, and in fact it takes 6 frames to rise up to a height of 1 foot. So the time in the air is very easy to find from that table. The total time in the air would be 6 frames of jump time going up, and then 6 frames of jump time coming down. So the total hang time would be 12 frames for a jump that has a height of 1 foot. Now, here's a scene from Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, and you can notice that in this scene, the time in the air is significantly longer than you would find in realistic jumping. So the characters, even though their jumps are, they don't rise very high, they spend a lot of time in the air. Now, of course, the reason is that this was filmed using wire work, so the actors here are being supported by wires and held up in the air much longer than they would be in a normal jump. This wire work is also commonly used in motion capture because it's even simpler in that with motion capture you don't have to paint out the wires in the scene as you do with live action. Now, wire work tends to distort the timing in jumps in that the characters spend much more time in the air than they would given the height of their jumps. But this is a phys dev design decision. So in Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, the idea is that the Kung Fu masters are able to essentially manipulate the laws of physics, and that gives them a somewhat magical aspect. So, in summary, the path of action of a character's center of gravity is always a parabolic arc. The apparent path of action may be flattened if the center of gravity shifts location within the body, and this commonly happens when the character raises their arms or legs. As with falling motion, the time in the air for a jump only depends on the height of the jump, and we saw the table that gives you the matching time given the height, or you can go the other way given the time. You can find how high the jump would have to be. And finally, we commonly see this timing distorted in special action sequences where the wire work is used, which distorts the time in the air by keeping the characters in the air longer than they normally would given the height of their jumps.